Good afternoon, everyone. My name is P. Aruna Kumari. Today I am here to present my project presentation. My project title is Air Contamination Prediction and Comparison Using Machine Learning Algorithms. Under the guidance of Dr. Y. Vijayalata, Madam Professor of Gokaraju Rangaraju Institute of Engineering and Technology. Coming to my abstract, dealing with air contaminations present a significant environmental hazard in the urban environment. So constant monitoring of pollution data allows local officials to assess the city's current traffic situations and make the appropriate decisions. Arrangement of the Internet of Things based sensors has extensively changed the elements of forcing the air quality. So in the previous research has used a variety of artificial intelligence learning algorithms. However, a thorough evaluation of these techniques is required to gain a better understanding of their handling time for a variety of data sets. And this paper is mainly tends to the test of forcing the air quality index, and the main aim is to predict the contamination on different studies using two machine learning algorithms, neural networks and support vector machines, and the data set which is downloaded from the Central Pollution Control Board, which is AQI, air quality index. And the proposed machine learning model is used to predict the Delhi air quality index data and compare it with the actual and predicted data. Coming to the introduction, air is the most fundamental characteristic asset for the presence and endurance of the whole species of Earth. So it is a mixture of solid particles and gases in the air. These particles and gases can come from the car, truck, exhaust factories, dust pollen, mold spores, volcanoes and wildfires. And these pollutants can harm the human health. Like it has side effects to the burning eyes, loose nose, itching in the throat, headaches, skin allergies, respiratory problems, and so on, and to also harm the environment and cause the property damage. So in these strategies, at first an actual model is planned and information is coded within numerical conditions. So apart that, the strategies experience that the effect of drawbacks like it will less accuracy while prediction, which means that they are unable to predict the maximum and minimal levels of pollutions. And also the inappropriate methodologies for output prediction, implementation of complex algorithms, and also amalgamation of old and new data. Next, proposed system. The main proposed system of this paper are LSTM model. It is used to propose to anticipate air pollution pollutants concentrations in Delhi. To deal with the forces surrounding air quality in Delhi, India. LSTM is LSTM based model to predict the hourly fine PM concentrations. So AQI is a air quality index. It recollects to measure the surrounding air nature of Delhi for the next hour, and the results will be differentiated and benchmark process will be showed that the proposed model executed for the better outcomes. Advantages of proposed system. So the LSTM and RNN models. LSTM is a long short term memory based model to predict the hourly fine PM concentrations. RNNs have been used to create a sequential information data for many deep learning applications, including translations. So this is a framework to obtain the long-term PM 2.5 trends for time series data, and it also been used as a framework for large-scale long-term time series data for PM forecasting and LSTM based to predict hourly fine PM concentrations. Next, methodology. So LSTM is a supervised learning algorithm. So the model must be provided with the validated data and yield records. So LSTM model to predict the considerations of O3, PM 2.5, CO and NOx at a particular area in Delhi. So they served the adaption display from the information and saw the LSTM variant is profitably in including air uncommon assessing. So we have these are the module descriptions like data acquisition, data pre-processing, LSTM model, model fitting, model evaluation parameters, and training model. So data acquisition is nothing but a process of collecting and organizing the information. And whereas the data pre-processing, it is the process of transferring the raw data into an understandable format. Like the quality of the data should be checked before applying the machine learning or data mining algorithms. Next one is the LSTM model. So LSTM models that prevents them from dealing with continuous data streams that are not split into the after effects. So it paints the cells in a state before incorporating it has a contribution to the versatile, like via the cells self-repetitive associations, adaptively ignoring or resetting the portable's memory. Next is the model fitting. The data set is required for data planning and testing. The pre-processed data set is then applied to the retention that will be used to set the network hindrances ahead of the time. And after that, the model evaluation parameters and the training model. So in the training model, for all the stations, for example, for all the stations, the first instance was for PM2.5 AQI, and the second was for PM10 AQI, and the third case was for AQIF guess. As a result, there are a total 9 data preparations of training data, where each was prepared utilizing 8 regression models. So 8 regression models for normalized AQI of PM2.5. Comparatively, outputs were brought in for the other 8 cases. Next, this is the LSTM architecture. In that we have input layer, LSTM layers, dense layer and output layer. These are all part of the model. So the input layer is used to create the sequential data for the LSTM layer. So each sequence consists of k feature vectors, where k is the number of time steps. And a vector is denoted by x in the diagram, where xt is a feature vector at time, and xt contains the concentration of pollutant. So in this manner, the sequential data is transferred into the controlled insights before being entered into the LSTM form. And these are the meteorological parameters. So as well as it also the climatic limits, namely temperature, relative humidity, solar radiations, wind speed, and the concentration of pollutants. Next, results. In the results, the proposed LSTM model used in the development of the multiple Python packages, and it also standardized the data in the range of 0 to 1. So for plotting all the graphs, matplotlib is used in Python. The number of LSTM layers, the number of gadgets in each LSTM layer, and the number of edges in each LSTM layer all influence the design of the LSTM form. So these limitations are adjusted in order to achieve a balance between the underfitting and overfitting. So dropout layers are also used to prevent the overfitting in the model. So these layers remove devices from the immediate rejoin at random points. So throughout the preparation process, preventing the unit from co-adjusting the excessively. So using an ADAM analyzer for 20 epochs and 70 batches. So ADAM is a collection of rules for replacing the stochastic angle, and it is instruction in the deep learning models also. It combines the best parts of the ADAM grad and RMS proc algorithms to create a boost calculation that can handle the minor slants and difficulties. So as a result, a priority adaption evaluation for algorithm execution on the test data set is necessary. So it real estimates are used to evaluate styles based on the arrangements of the adaption, and it also allocated venture and so on. Next, these are the history of loss. And in this, an epoch is a term used in the machine learning and indicates the number of passes the entire training data set the machine learning algorithm has completed. So in this, it's running through the whole data 20 times at a time, and it takes the 70 records. Next, the model loss graph. So in the model loss graph, it implemented plotting the data to see how the model loss is decreasing. So which is a good indicator as the epoch increases. And next one is the AQI predicted output. This is the final output. It depicts their efforts in forecasting the data by considering the test data, and it is used to run the model effectively. So the blue lines are the actual data and the red lines are the prediction data. So as a result, the final result projections are proved to be extremely accurate. Next, the conclusion. So in the recent advances in deep learning, data on models have inspired a rapid growth of their use in the insightful and current day scenarios. So air pollution in the form of plentiful PM, which mixes the liquid and strong atoms. So in Delhi, the most serious ecological worry in air pollution has fine PM, which consists of the fluid and powerful molecules and is detrimental to human health. So in the study, we proposed PCN models of fine PM fixation utilizing LSTM and DE approaches and thought about their RMSE estimates for 10 day PM10 and PM2.5 fixation forecast results for CO. So the stress results indicated that our proposed estimator can accurately forecast the LSTM and DAE models. In the future, the further process can be done to do non-required significant concentrations on models in order to achieve the more explicit results with more instructional arrangements. And we will also use the GIS-based spatial data to show our structure. These are the references which I have used. Thank you. Any queries?